Hello everyone, I hope you all are ready now. So today we are going to discuss some interesting questions which are based on the concept of probability. So the first question which you can see on the screen is, when a die is thrown, list the outcomes of an event of getting a prime number. Now you see, when you have a dice in your hand, you can see there are six faces, and on each face you see a number which is represented by some number of dots. So if you see, we have the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 on the faces of the die. Now you tell me, on how many faces do you see a prime number? Okay, do you think 1 is a prime number? No, 1 is not a prime number. It's not a prime number, or it's even not a composite number. Yes, sir, we say that 1 is a natural number. You are right. 1 is an integer also. Yes. So what about 2? Do you think 2 is a prime number? So what is a prime number? Yes, a prime number is a number which has only two factors, 1 or itself. So if you see 2, 2 is a prime number. You are right. And what about 3? 3 is also a prime number. What about 4? 4 is not a prime number. You are right. And 5, 5 is also a prime number. So what about 6? Yes, 6 is not a prime number. So the question says, when a die is thrown, list the outcomes of an event of getting a prime number. So the prime number outcomes are 2, 3 and 5. Okay, am I adding a question here? What is the probability of getting an even number when we throw a die, or when we roll a die? So probability of getting an even number. How many even numbers can you see? Yes, 2, 4 and 6, they are even numbers. So what is the probability of getting an even number? So there are 3 favorable outcomes, 2, 4 and 6. And how many total outcomes are there? There are 6 total number of outcomes. You know that formula of finding the probability is number of favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. So the answer will be 1 by 2. Okay, tell me, what is the probability of getting a prime number? What will be your answer now? You know, you have already found the prime number outcomes. How many prime numbers are there? Here, when you see the faces of the die, there are numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and out of this, 3 are prime numbers. So what is the probability of getting a prime number? So probability of getting a prime number is also 3 upon 6. As you can see that 2, 3 and 5 are the favorable outcomes. So these are 3 favorable outcomes. So 3 divided by total number of outcomes, that gives us 1 upon 2. I hope this is clear to you. Okay, moving on to next. And the next question is, second part, a composite number. Let me see, I'm just copying this and moving on here so that you can tell me, out of these numbers, which of them are composite numbers? Yes, which of them are composite numbers? Tell me fast. Is 1 a composite number? No, it is not. What about 2? 2 is a prime number. And 3 is also a prime number. 4 is a composite number and it is the smallest composite number. 5 is a prime number, and 6 is a composite number. So how many composite numbers are there in this? Yes, there are 2 composite numbers, 2 and 6. So we have listed the outcomes. Okay, can you tell me what will be the probability of getting a composite number when we roll a single dice, or dice, getting a composite number? So that will be equal to how many favorable outcomes are there? 2. And how many total outcomes are there? 6. So that gives us 1/3. Is it clear to you? Okay, coming on to next. Let us see. When a die is thrown, list the outcomes of an event of getting a number less than 4. Just tell me fast. A number less than 4. Which are the favorable outcomes? Less than 4. It will be 1, 2, and 3. So, can you tell me what will be the probability of getting a number less than 4? Getting a number less than 4. Now you know what is the formula. Favorable outcomes is 3 and total number of outcomes is 6. So the answer will be 1/2. Right? Okay, now I'm twisting this question. And my question is, a number less than or equal to 4. Then tell me what will be the answer. I'm repeating, a number less than or equal to 4. So yes, in that case, you are going to consider the number 4 also, and the favorable outcomes will be 1, 2, 3 and 4. And what will be the probability in that case? So probability of getting a number less than or equal to 4 will be 4/6. And you can simplify, and that gives you 2/3. Interesting. Okay, moving on to next. Now just tell me this. A number more than or equal to 3. See, here we have got the similar thing. I'm copying this. Okay, now you tell me out of these, a number less than or equal to 3. So you will be considering outcomes 3, 4, 5 and 6. So how many total favorable outcomes are there? 4. So if I ask you, find the probability of getting a number more than or equal to 3. More than or equal to 3. Now tell me what will be the answer. What is the total number of favorable outcomes in this case? Yes, it is 4. And total outcomes are 6. So what is the answer? Answer is 2/3. Okay. So now you are going to tell me next question, and it's a practice question. A bag contains slips numbered 1 to 20. Here also we are going to consider questions which are based on the numbers. So one slip is drawn at random. Find the probability that the slip drawn is a number more than or equal to 13. First you tell me, list the outcomes. So what are the outcomes in this case? Okay, I'm writing here, list the outcomes, favorable outcomes. So what are the favorable outcomes? We have to take numbers more than or equal to 13. So that will be 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. So how many total are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 are there. So what is the required probability? So we write it, probability of a number more than or equal to 13 is equal to, now tell me, 8 divided by how many total slips are there? 20. So we can see, simplify this, 4 2s are 8 and 4 5s are 20. So answer is 2 upon 5. Right? Okay, let us take one more question. Okay, now you are again given numbers from 1 to 20. So a multiple of 3. Just list the outcomes first. List the favorable outcomes. Yes, multiples of 3, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. We will be considering this. Okay, now tell me how many of them are there? That is 6. So what is the required probability? Probability of getting a multiple of 3. Will be equal to, now you tell me what is the answer. Yes, answer will be 6 divided by 20. So you can simplify, 2 3s are 6 and we get 10 in the denominator. So answer is 3 upon 10. Is it clear? Okay, let us take another one. A multiple of 5. Tell me the answer. What is the probability of getting a multiple of 5? Now you can simply tell me what are the outcomes, favorable outcomes. Multiples of 5. 5, 10, 15. Will you be considering 20? Yes, of course. Because we have to consider number from 1 to 20. 20 is included in that. So, multiples of 5, 5, 10, 15, 20. So, how many of them are there? We have 4 favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes, that is 20. So, what is the answer? Answer is 1 upon 5. Is it clear? Okay. Let me now give you another question and now you are going to do this. So there are slips numbered 1, 4, 6, 8, 10, 21, 43, 23. Specific slips are there. 1, 4, 6, 8, 10, 21, 43, 23 in a bag. So, how many total slips are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 slips are there. And it is saying one slip is drawn at random. Find the probability that the slip drawn is a multiple of 5. Yes, tell me how you are going to do this. Multiple of 5. You just tell me out of the slips which are provided, do you see any of them which is a multiple of 5? Okay, 1 is not, 4 is not, 6, 8, no, 10. Yes, we see one slip, that is 10, number 10 is a multiple of 5. So, we will be writing number of favorable outcomes is equal to 1. total outcomes, total number of outcomes. Yes, count how many of them are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 are there. So required probability of getting a multiple of 5 is equal to 1/8. Interesting. Okay, let us now take up another question. Let me duplicate this. Okay, now I'm writing a multiple of 3. Just tell me out of the slips, 1, 4, 6, 8, 10, 21, 43, 23. Do you see some multiples of 3 in it? Yes, we have 6 and 21. Okay, so how many of them are there? 2. 2 multiples of 3 are there. So total outcomes are 8. So the probability of getting a multiple of 3 will be 2/8, and after simplifying, it gives us 1/4. Okay, can you frame one question? This is the second part. Can you frame one question? Let us try to learn how we can frame questions. Any question out of the slips you can think of? Okay, let me write down a number greater than 6. Quickly tell me, just see, is 1 greater than 6? No. Is 4 greater than 6? No. Is 6 greater than 6? No. 8? Yes. So we got 1 favorable outcomes. 10? Yes. 21? Yes. 43? Yes. 23? Yes. So how many favorable outcomes are there? 5. So total number of outcomes are 8. So probability of getting a number greater than 6. A number greater than 6 will be equal to 5/8. Okay, so I hope this is clear to all of you how we, you know, consider such questions. So let me move on and take up another question. Here I am writing the question. And the question says, a bag contains slips numbered from 3 to 20. A slip is drawn at random. Find the probability that the slip drawn is, now we are going to frame questions. Okay, let us make some questions. Can you think of some question based on this situation? Just tell me. So you are given slips in a bag and they are named, numbered from 3 to 20. So first tell me how many total outcomes are there, total number of outcomes. And please read the question carefully. I am just taking your attention to some specific words, so you have to be very, very careful. From 3 to 20. From 3 to 20 meaning 3 is also included. So till 20, how many are there? If I say from 1 to 20, you say 20 slips are there. From 3 to 20, that means you have to exclude 1 and 2. So how many slips will be there? Yes, 18 slips will be there. What is another way of counting? We need to see from 3 to 20. From 3 to 20. So how do we do this? 20 minus 3 plus 1. So what is 20 minus 3? 20 minus 3 is 17 plus 1. That gives us total number of slips, because here it is written from 3 to 20. So from 3 meaning 3 is also included. So what is the total number of outcomes? So total number of outcomes is equal to 18. So now we can frame one question. Find the probability that the slip drawn is, probability of getting a multiple of 7. Tell me, a multiple of 7 from 3 to 20. Quickly you can think and just tell. First multiple is 7, second multiple is 14. Obviously 21 will not come. So how many multiples of 7 are there from 3 to 20? There are 2 multiples. So 2 divided by total slips, that is 18. So what is the final answer? Final answer is 1 upon 9. Is it clear to you? Okay, I'm taking the same question. And let me see, you have to tell me, what is the probability of getting an even number? Yes, probability of getting an even number. You can count from 3 to 20, how many even numbers are there? Okay, you want to count. 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and 20 also. So how many even numbers are there? 9 out of 18. 18 slips are there. So what is the answer? Answer is 1 by 2. Is it clear to all of you how we have done these questions? Thank you so much, and I now I will be supplying you with the one worksheet, so you can solve the questions which are based on these worksheets. Bye bye, take care.